Now, before I begin with my topic, I would just like to tell you all that street rats are disgusting. And I don't mean the Aladdin kind of street rats. They're disgusting, they're ugly, and they're everywhere, and I don't care, I just hate them. My sister complains to me about the raccoons infesting her trash cans in Canada, and I'm just sitting there thinking, why would anyone complain about raccoons? They're absolutely adorable. I mean, at least it's not street rats. But there are much more interesting creatures aside from rats and raccoons. And here I bring to you those exotic animals, ranging from a hummingbird imposter to a sneezing Michael Jackson monkey. So first of them are these guys. Now, aside from looking like a post-operation Michael Jackson, these monkeys were discovered in the Asian country of Myanmar, and as you can see, they're called the Santos monkeys. They curl their heads to protect them from the water because the odd shape of their noses allows the water to easily fall into their nostrils. And just like any other exotic animal that humanity stumbles across, they are nearing extinction due to hunters killing them for their delectable meat. Next. The ice fish. They were first discovered by Detlef Rostad in 1927, and they inhabit the shores around Antarctica. They have fangs and a ghostly white body due to the lack of hemoglobin in their body, which have puzzled researchers over 60 years because hemoglobin is the substance that carries oxygen in our bodies. And they have managed to survive with little of them. Next is the gopher eel. Also called the pelican eel, and one of the main reasons why I hate the deep sea. The females lay their eggs in such deep waters that their offspring can't really survive, which is why there are little numbers of them. They unhinge their jaws to swallow enormous prey, and the prey are attracted to their brilliant bioluminescent orbs on the ends of their tail, and their flexible stomachs help them in digesting their prey. The next is the hummingbird hawk moth. And as you can see from their name, they look like hummingbirds and a moth. They are found in Southern Europe and Asia. They have proboscis like a hummingbird or a butterfly and can split into two tubes when they need to be cleaned. Their sac in the head expands when they inhale and deflates when they exhale, which helps them in sucking up nectar. And the flying frog. They only come down from their trees to mate, and they are also known as the parachute frog. They have strong membranes in between their fingers and toes, which help them glide. At first, scientists thought it would be for swimming, but they're actually for gliding. So if you think flying cockroaches were bad enough, now we have flying frogs. Next is the salpa. They live off the coast of California, and they're made up of smaller organisms. So that's just not one organism, those are like planktons and other species. They have the ability to clone themselves, and they may look harmless, but they have already destroyed two fishing nets when they were captured, and they have also destroyed a nuclear power plant in California. And their ability to adapt to temperatures and immunity to human populations make scientists think they will soon overpopulate the ocean. Now the red purple frog, which is also aside from the fact of having a color that amphibians shouldn't have, they are also quite plump and they have a ridiculous face. They start out as tadpoles, just like any other frog. Except for the fact that the tadpoles have they have snouts, still a beak. Their short limbs are meant to dig underground, so they mostly live underground, and they only come up for 2 weeks to the surface to mate. And now lastly are the blanket octopus, which are also known as the Superman or Batman octopus, which for me, I think, is unfair with Marvel Comics. The females are you can easily distinguish the females from the males because they are 2 meters or 6 feet longer than the males. The blanket they have are used to capture prey, and if they can capture prey with their blankets, they can detach pieces of themselves to make them appear more appealing. So talk about beauty standards. And that is all.